Welcome to Fast Applications of Neuroplasticity. My name is Mike Studer, your host for part 16, where we're going to talk about maximizing attention using efficacious intensity. And if you were watching closely in part 15, you saw a preview to this, and you'll also know that the color scheme has changed here. We're now transitioning out of our final installment in Maximizing Attention, the mini series. Here's what we covered over the last 8 series of FAN, and these modules 8 through 16 look at different tools and techniques you can use in the clinic to maximize attention. Here we are utilizing efficacious intensity, which can be thought of as environmental rather than therapeutic alliance, or engagement leveraging self-efficacy. Let's take a peek at how that is. When we look at maximizing attention through efficacious intensity, we see that around the wheel here, several different variables that we can help to manipulate so that the learner, patient, customer, client, student, athlete, has the best opportunity to increase their attention because they have a strong belief, efficacy, in the treatment and the environment. So efficacious intensity is based on elevating efficacy. I believe I can control and can do something about my lot, stake, outcome, etc. Therefore, I'm willing to actually try even harder so that I can take advantage of this great environment. So the environment that they're in for learning, maybe they're at a baseball camp, or maybe this rehabilitation center specializes in spinal cord injury, or maybe they're in a great environment because they know that other people around them are wanting to learn as well, or that there's great speakers, educators, therapists, coaches, etc. Now, the vicarious experiences would be on a more direct relationship that the individuals that are helping me learn have been with other people like me and have had successful experiences. I'll leave it that at that brief summary statement. Social cohesion means that there's other people around me going through things that are similar to what I'm going through, and we are all, quote, in this together. They are improving. I have strong efficacy in belief that I will also similarly be able to improve. Unexpected success. Oftentimes you'll hear me refer to this as moments of unexpected success in therapy, MUST, where someone has an aha moment and they achieve a personal best, move an extremity that hadn't been moving, perform something without assistance that recently required assistance. So unexpected success causes me to enhance my expectations and also to believe that I have a more widely held and grounded sense of efficacy. I am improving, and I didn't even expect to be able to improve in this direction today. Expectations or hope, that can come from measurements and more of that external focus or gamification. I see myself improving. It's been proven to me, and therefore I have hope to improve even more. You'll see in the sidebar over here, the enriched environment, nature also gives us an impression of the different variables that are relevant to elevate people's efficacious based intensity. And then also related to that are my beliefs, past experiences for my nuclear family or myself, unexpected success. These elevate my beliefs. The enriched environment elevates the other attributes, and therefore bidirectionally we have efficacious intensity. I want to thank you for watching the entire mini series on increasing attention, and you'll know that past and future episodes of FAN can be found on Instagram and YouTube at Mike Studer DPT. Again, I'm Mike Studer, and thanks for watching FAN.